What is going on, Diablo 2 fans? My name is Dobrynski. I hope all of you guys had a great 2018, and I just wanted to take a quick second to say thank you again for the support. It really does mean a lot. But with that being said, we're going to kick off 2019 by answering 10 frequently asked magic finding questions that I get all the time on my Diablo 2 streams. These are repeats, and I don't mind answering these questions, but I figured it'd be a good idea to make a video just going over the reoccurring FAQs. So guys, I really do hope you enjoy it, but let's jump in. All right, so question number one, how much magic find should I have while I'm farming in Diablo 2? Now, this is a difficult question for me to give you a specific like set number because there's a lot of different factors that you have to take into consideration, like your character level, your character's gear, what character you're farming with, where you're farming with, the player's difficulty setting, things like that. There's a lot of different factors that you have to take into consideration. There are some specific builds that excel in particular areas as well, and they're poor in other areas, so that's another factor. But kind of a general consensus is that somewhere in the range of 200% to 400% magic find, that's a really good starting point. There are particular niche characters that kind of blow that out of the water, like a Pendlezerker, a Pendle Javazon, Pitzerker, or an Ancient Tunnels Blizzard Sorceress. Those are some examples of some characters that can stack 600-700% magic find easily and still clear the particular area that they're farming really efficiently. But I would say that say you're farming an area like Chaos Sanctuary and you have about 350-400% magic find, and you find that your clear speed is really slow, I would maybe try and pull off some magic find and try and bump your clear speed up a little bit, and vice versa. Say that you have like 200% magic find and you find that you're clearing the area without any difficulty, like you're just running through the area no problem, that's a scenario where I would maybe try and bump your MF up a little bit more. But somewhere in the range of 200 to 400 MF is a good starting point, I should say, and then just kind of tailor it from there based on the character that you're farming and where you're farming. All right, so question number two, what is the best player's difficulty setting to magic find in Diablo 2 if you're playing on single player? Now, this is a difficult question to give you like a concrete number because it's going to, again, vary on some different factors, like what you're magic finding for and where you're magic finding, like if it's bosses or super uniques, etc. Now, I did make a detailed video about the Player's X command. I have the link for that video in the description below, so make sure you check it out if you want to know more about the Player's X command. But I'm basically going to give you a quick summary, in my opinion, of the best player's difficulty settings for what you're magic finding for, if that makes sense. So if you're solely targeting uniques in level 85 areas, then honestly, the best player's difficulty setting is going to be players 1, because if you're solely targeting uniques, you're going to be focusing on champions and boss packs only, because they have higher chances of dropping uniques versus regular white monsters, and they always drop one item no matter what the player's difficulty setting is. So players 7 or players 1 is going to have no bearing on the chance of them dropping like a Crown of Ages. So just farm players 1 and stack as much magic find as you possibly can. Super uniques are similar as well. Now, they're monsters like Pendle or Threshsocket, where they always have the same name and they spawn in the same area. These monsters will always drop 2 items no matter what the player's difficulty setting is. So again, similar to champions and boss packs in level 85 areas, in my opinion, it's best to farm players 1 difficulty and increase your magic find as much as you can, because players 1 or players 7, again, is going to have no bearing on the chances of them dropping a really nice unique. Now, endgame bosses differ a little bit. So an endgame boss, I mean like Andariel or Mephisto or Diablo, the player's difficulty setting does have an impact on their no drop rate chances. So players 1, 3, or 5 is only going to have an impact. Player 7 doesn't. But ideally, the best player's difficulty setting for endgame bosses is players 3, because it's the best combination of decreasing the no drop rate and then still being able to farm that boss efficiently. Players 5, the no drop rate is slightly lower, but it's such a negligible difference between players 5 and players 3 that it really just makes sense to stack more magic find and increase your clear speed on players 3 difficulty. And finally, if you're farming for runes or jewels or charms, then your best bet is going to be clearing the majority of white monsters and champions and boss packs in highly dense areas and running on player 7 difficulty if your character is strong enough, because player 7 is going to decrease the no drop rate on white monsters to the lowest that it can be. So you're mass farming and killing as much stuff as you possibly can on player 7, and that's going to increase your chances of dropping more jewels, charms, uniques, and stuff like that. So player 7, if that's what you're targeting for. Question number 3, where is the best place to find blank item? Now, I don't know the best odds to find every single item in the game. I really don't. I wish I was that smart, but I'm not. Definitely not that smart. But I have a link for a website. It's in the description below, so you can check it out. But it's called Silopen, or D2 Silopen. It's a drop calculator that I use to calculate where the best drop odds for, you know, certain items off of particular monsters. So you can refer to it if you want to know where the exact best place to drop an item like Herald of Zakarum, for example. But that's a particular item that I know that the best place to drop it is off of Nightmare Mephisto. But farming a particular item, it's not always the best route to go with the best monster that drops it, if that makes any sense. So Nightmare Mephisto might be the best place to drop Haws, and maybe you'll get it in 1,000 runs, but there's a good chance that probably within 1,000 Hell Mephisto runs that you could get Haws as well. I mean, you might not get it, it's RNG, but my point that I'm trying to make is that farming 1,000 runs off of Hell Mephisto in the end of it is going to drop you more items and better gear than it is farming 1,000 runs on Nightmare Mephisto for specifically that one item. So it's not always the best bet to farm, you know, the best drop odds monster for a particular item. But if you guys want to know what is the best drop odds, if you're that type of person, the link for that website is in the description below. And it's also, I also made a video too, make sure you check it out as well. It's the top 5 Diablo 2 websites. It's one of my lowest viewed videos, but it's funny because it's one of my most frequently asked questions about where's the best, you know, website to get this information, or where can I, you know, find out that stuff, or build ideas, what website, whatever. It's all covered in that video in my top 5 Diablo 2 websites, so make sure you check that video out. But that will help you out for the best drop odds for a particular item to fall off of a monster. Question number 4, does magic find help for rune drops? The simple answer is no. Magic find has absolutely zero bearing on your chances to drop high runes. Now, there are some specific strategies and areas that you can magic find to increase your odds of dropping high runes, and I'll highlight those. But the first, and it's really easy, is just upping your player's difficulty setting, or farming if you can in large player groups on Battle.net, and just kill as many monsters as you can and open as many poppables as you can. Higher difficulty settings, white monsters are going to have a lower no drop chance, and so a lower chance of not dropping item is the same thing as more of a chance of dropping item, and that particular item could be a high rune. So a higher player difficulty setting and then just maximizing your killing is going to increase the efficiency of high rune drops. Now the other strategy you can for maximizing rune drops is targeting specific areas in the game that have higher rune drop odds. Now I have guides on these particular videos, and I have the links for them in the description below, so you can check them out. But those areas are the Countess, Travancore, Lower Kurost, and then Cows. Now I do have guide videos on the Countess, Lower Kurost, and Trav, because there is a little bit more to it than farming cows. Cows is really just, you know, players 3 or 7 if you can do it, and just kill everything and then just repeat. There's not really a strategy to cows, but there is more to the other areas that are listed below. So I have guide videos for those 3 areas if you want to check it out. But the simple question, or sorry, the simple answer to the question is no, magic find has absolutely zero bearing on the chances of rune drops in Diablo 2. Question number 5. Why are you farming on players 7 difficulty and not players 8? Now, the detailed answer to this question, again, is in the Players X Command video that I've made, and the link for it is in the description below if you want a more detailed explanation. But basically, increasing the player's difficulty on odd numbers decreases the no drop rate on specific monsters, like I said, white monsters and bosses, but it caps out at players 7 difficulty. So the difference between players 7 and 8 is players 8 has the same no drop rate as players 7. It's just the monsters are harder to kill, they do more damage, and they give you slightly more experience. But since the majority of my Diablo 2 streaming is trying to complete the Holy Grail, I really just want to maximize the odds of, you know, runes dropping or jewels. I don't really care about the experience. So player 7 is the best combination of decreasing the no drop rate. So there's really just no benefit to farming players 8. I mean, as simple as that sounds, like, for the type of farming that I'm doing, players 8 is no benefit. The monsters are just harder to kill, they do more damage without the chances of, or better chance of, an item dropping for me. Alright, so question number 6. What makes level 85 areas so special in Diablo 2 for magic finding? Why do I farm areas like the pits, ancient tunnels, etc.? Now, I did make a very detailed guide. It's a previously made video. It's all the level 85 areas in Diablo 2, and I break down specifically what makes them so important. But the quick and easy cut dry answer is that champions and boss packs in level 85 areas can drop any item in the game, and that's because their monster level matches the quality level of a particular treasure class item, and then it can roll set or unique. Now again, I explain this in more detail in the video if you want to check it out, but yeah, basically any item from champions and boss packs specifically can drop here, and it's an extremely efficient and effective way for magic finding for all the items in Diablo 2. Question number 7. What are all of the level 85 areas in Diablo 2? Now, like I mentioned in the previous question, that guide video, I go into great detail about all the different areas, but I'll quickly ring them off for you guys just to answer the question. So in Act 1, we have 2 level 85 areas. We have the Mausoleum. It's in the burial grounds. It's kind of a cool place to magic find. The density is not the best. I mean, the monsters are kind of spread out quite a bit, but there is no cold or fire immunes in that area, so it's a cool area to magic find early on with like a blizzard sorceress or fire sorceress. And the second area is the pits. It's located in the Tamo Highland. You just take the waypoint from the Outer Cloister, you just teleport down to it. It's really easy to find. It's a great area to magic find, good monster density, you can roll a nice map. The only kind of downside to the pits is you need a little bit stronger of a character to magic find there. The archers can be a bit of a pain in the butt. But yeah, those are the 2 areas in Act 1. There's 2 level 85 areas in Act 2, and one of them is amazing and one of them is horrible. So we'll start off with the really crappy one, and that's the Maggot Lair. Level 2 and level 3 of the Maggot Lair is level 85. So technically, any item in the game can drop there. And it's also an area where very few fire immune monsters spawn. So you can farm there with a fire sorceress pretty effectively, clear speed wise, but the tunnels, they're really narrow corridors. It's really hard to see items drop, and it's just a pain in the butt, especially if you're playing on Battle.net, because you don't have the same map. Like, you have the same map over and over again in single player, so you kind of know where to teleport to where champions are in single player. But again, I do not recommend farming this area. And the second one that we have is the Ancient Tunnels. This is probably one of the best locations in the game to magic find, and is definitely the best location for a Blizzard Sorceress. There's next to no cold immunes that spawn in this area. It's easy to find, you can roll a good map, you can get a lot of champions and boss packs, and you can virtually farm this character with a naked Blizzard Sorceress, because again, next to no cold immunes ever spawn in this area. So yeah, we have the Far Oasis, Mega Lair, which is horrible in Act 2, and then we have the Ancient Tunnels, which is an amazing place to magic find. For Act 3, there's actually quite a few level 85 areas, but they're not really popular because monster density is pretty poor, but I'll list them off anyways. So first we have the Sewers, level 2. not a very good area to farm, extremely poor monster density. Like, I maybe get a monster pack every other run. There are super chests in this area. There's six of them, so you can, I believe there's six, sorry. You can farm them, but it's gonna be more efficient to farm lower Kuros because you don't need to start, you know, and work your way down to the second level. Just in lower Kuros, the super chests are already there. So I don't recommend farming this area. And the other three level 85 areas in Act 3 are the Forgotten Temple, the Ruined Fane, and the Disused Reliquary. Two of them are located in the Kuros Causeway. And the other one is located in Upper Kuros. Again, they're okay areas to farm. You almost never run into fire immunes outside of the Blood Divers, but their fire immunity can be broken with Infinity. The maps are okay, they're a little small, but champions and boss packs in these areas do have the potential to drop every item in the game. There's two really large level 85 areas in Act 4, and that is the entire River of Flame and the Chaos Sanctuary. They're both great areas to magic find. There's one thing that I should point out though about the Chaos Sanctuary, and that is that the seal bosses in Diablo himself, they're capped out at dropping TC 84 items, so the really nice TC 87 uniques can't drop from them specifically. But the good thing is that the champions and boss packs within the Chaos Sanctuary can still drop those really nice TC 87 uniques. And the final set of level 85 areas in Act 5 is the Worldstone Keep level 1, 2, and 3, and then the entire throne room, and then the Bale Waves. And then I guess Bale himself, he's not really a level 85 area, but Bale can drop every item in the game. So they're good areas to farm. You just have to have a very developed character because you're basically facing the most powerful monsters in the game, and they still have the same chance of dropping an item as a regular champion does in the pits. So that's why usually Act 1 level 85 areas are, you know, a little bit more popular because the monsters are easy to kill. But I mean, if you have a very powerful, you know, Jawazon, a Hammerdin, or a really powerful sorceress, you can, you know, farm Bale Waves or farm, you know, the Worldstone Keep and still get those good drops. But I just wanted to point out that they are a lot harder areas to farm, and that's why they're probably not as popular. And the actual drop odds of items off of the Bale Waves and Bale himself are relatively low too. I mean, you have a better chance of getting a good item off of like an 85 area like the pit or running Pendle than you actually do off of Bale and his Bale Waves. Question number 8. What is the best player's difficulty setting to farm Pendle on? Now, I know this question is similar to the what's the best player setting to magic find on question that I answered earlier, but I get asked this question so many times, so I'm going to answer it regardless. Now, Pendle is a super unique. Super uniques always drop two items regardless of the player's difficulty setting. So, in most cases, players one is optimal. Just maximize your MF, kill Pendle. Pendle is the guy that's going to drop the good items, not his minions. Changing his player's difficulty setting for him will not do anything. So always farm him on players one difficulty, with the exception of two characters. That would be the Blizzard Sorceress and the Pendle Jawazon. Even those characters, I recommend players one, but they're kind of the exception where Blizzard has really good AoE and Lightning Fury has really good AoE on the Jawazon as well. So those two characters, I think that they're okay to farm players three on if you want to decrease the no drop rate on Pendle's minions to maybe get, you know, the chance of a nice jewel or charm or rune or something. Those are the two exceptions. Other than that, guys, just always farm him players one. There's no point of going any higher difficulty for Pendle. Second last question, question number 9. Now, this is kind of a repeat theme, but I get asked this so many times, so I don't care. I'm gonna repeat it and give you the answer. And it's something along the lines of, why are you farming on players one difficulty? You can't drop anything on that setting. Again, this is so wrong. It depends on what you're farming for. Now, I agree if you're trying to maximize rune drops, jewels and charms and stuff, you should be farming at a higher difficulty setting to reduce the no drop rate on white minions. But if you're solely targeting set and unique items, then you're going to be focusing on champion and boss packs in level 85 areas specifically, because these monsters have a much, much higher chance of dropping a unique item than the other regular white mobs do in those areas. And they're also guaranteed to drop one item regardless of the player's difficulty setting. So if you're farming on player 7 and then you kill, you know, 4 champion packs, Each one of those champions is going to drop one item each. It's going to be the exact same if you're farming on players one difficulty. But the reason why you farm on players one is because the monsters are easier to kill, which allows you to stack more magic find. You don't have to worry as much about damage, and then you can maximize your MF and still kill those monsters on a lower player difficulty setting with still having the same chance of dropping a really good unique as if you're farming player seven. So again, it totally depends on what you're targeting for, but if you're solely targeting for set and unique items, then players one difficulty in a level 85 area and maximizing your MF is going to be your best bet. Question number 10, the final most frequently asked magic finding related question that I get during my Diablo 2 live streams, and that is, what is the best character to start magic finding with in Diablo 2? And the answer is, hands down, no question, the Blizzard Sorceress. She is the number one best character to start magic finding with, and for a lot of different reasons. One, she has teleport, so right off the bat at level 18, you have teleport, you don't need Enigma, that's a huge bonus. Two, her cold mastery gives you minus cold res, reduces the cold resistance on monsters, so that significantly increases your damage against non-cold immune monsters, so you can easily clear level 85 areas like the Ancient Tunnels with practically a naked Blizzard Sorceress. And then the final reason is that you can Moat Trick Mephisto. Now, if you're not familiar with the Moat Trick, basically you kind of teleport down to Mephisto, you lure him across that lava moat, you teleport to the other side, and he'll just stay stuck on the other end, and he'll just kind of go back and forth, kind of like a dummy, doesn't know what's going on, and you can just sit and drop blizzards on him, and it's a really easy way to farm all of the base gear that you need to get your character off the ground with. So things like Aussie, Viper Magi, Shaco, Scalders, I mean, you can get SOJs if you're lucky, he can drop any of the jewelry, Arachnid's Mesh if you're really lucky. There's just so many great items that he can drop, and that's why he's honestly, if you need any item in Diablo 2 and it's treasure class 78 or below, Mephisto is your best bet to run. But yeah, for those reasons, hands down, the number one single best character to start magic finding with in Diablo 2 is the Blizzard Sorceress. There's literally no comparison. Well guys, there you have it. That is my list of the 10 most frequently asked magic finding related questions that I get during my Diablo 2 live streams. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you could throw a like on it and share it, I would really appreciate it. And even consider subscribing if you're new to my Diablo 2 YouTube channel. New weekly content, I usually try and stream once or twice a week and have a new video out every week as well. Again guys, just thank you so much for the support. We are growing and it is really amazing, and I could not do it without you guys. But thank you again, and I will see you on my next Diablo 2 stream or my next Diablo 2 video. Have a good one.